Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today we are going to take a close-up look on all the products that have just been released by Altinew, and then I'm also going to share three cards using some of the products from this release. This video is also part of a blog hoop, so make sure to visit my blog, you will find there all the details for the giveaways. And let's start with a small stamp for this month. This is the 2020 Little Stamp Set, which is great for all your New Year cards as well as for journaling. This is the Hello Winter stamp set. It comes with snow as well as lots and lots of sentiments that you can combine with a big winter word. And for this word, there is also a die that matches exactly the same script. This die set has two dies, one that cuts out the word and the other one that cuts out the outline. And of course, you can combine it with the sentiments from the stamp set. Moving on to a couple of stamp sets which are great for creating your own scenes. So the first one is called Wanderlust. It gives you a row of trees to create a scenery as well as a row of mountains. You can stamp multiples one on top of the other and create a little scene, and of course you can combine them with the sentiments that come in the kit. And it also gives you a little circle that can be used as the moon or the sun. Now the other one is called Winter Wishes, and it is one of the stamp sets that I will be using today. So you will see it in action. It gives you this lovely winter scene that you can stamp and color. You can even emboss it if you like, and lots of sentiments to play with. And at the back you can also see some inspiration. Altinew, just like always, has released lots of flower stamp sets. So let's start with the first one. This is the Rosy Outlook, and I will be using that as an example today. It is one of those layering stamp sets. It gives you those beautiful roses along with stems and leaves. At the back there is always a guide on how you can put these together, and there are matching dies as well as matching stencils and masks. If you need gorgeous flower stamp sets, Altinew is best on that. So let's take a look at another one. This is the Rose Blossom, again a layering stamp set. At the back you will find the guide, and take a look at how gorgeous this flower is going to look once you layer all the stamps. Now for this there are also matching dies. Now if you don't like layering stamp sets and prefer coloring your images, then this is the one for you. It has beautiful flowers. This is the Precious Peony stamp set, and I will be using this one today. It comes along with lovely sentiments that are quite versatile, such as congratulations, good job, you did it, and so on. And there are also matching dies available. You will have fun with this stamp set, especially if you like coloring and you can use your favorite coloring mediums. And lastly, here is another one with layering stamps again. This is the Grateful Heart. It gives you the layers as well as the outline, so you can either layer the stamps one on top of the other or just stamp the outline and color it in with your favorite mediums. For this stamp set, there are matching dies available as well as stencils and masks. Now another quite unique stamp set is this Dot Botanicals stamp set. It gives you a solid image of a branch as well as a dotted version of it that you can layer one on top of the other, or of course you can use them separately. And I think that if you stamp only the dotted version at your background, it would create a very subtle and lovely background for any flower card. And there are also matching dies available. Now if you like geometric shapes and tiles, then this is a stamp set for you. This is the Delicate Tiles, and it gives you a set of four stamps to create a design. These are four again, and again three, that you can layer one on top of the other, and you can see at the back the guide on how you can layer them. Just by using different combinations, you can come up with different colored tiles that you can play with on your card. If you love Portuguese tiles or Spanish tiles, I'm sure you will absolutely love this stamp set. Now this month Altinew has released a set of very unique dies. So these are the String Art dies, and as you can see it comes in three different shapes. This one doesn't cut out anything, it just creates dots on your paper. So you can use your needle and thread all through all those holes to create your design. So for example, this is the butterfly, this is the heart. Again, the heart doesn't cut out anything, only creates the dots for your needle. And you can get completely different looks depending on the colors of thread that you use, as well as the way that you thread it through those holes. Now, this is a nested rectangle die, and of course you can use just one or many of them to combine all those holes. If you love threads and needles, I'm sure these are going to be really fun for you. So now let's make a few cards so you can see some of those products in action. This is the Winter Wishes stamp set, and you can see the leaflet that gives you some ideas on how you can put a card together. I'm going to stamp the little scene on white cardstock, and I'm using black ink here, which is alcohol friendly since I am going to use my alcohol markers to color everything. So I use my Misty so that I can stamp it a couple of times to get a good impression. I am using my Altenew alcohol markers to add some color. You don't really need to spend a lot of time coloring this image since it is in the snow and most of it has to remain white. So I colored my cabin, now I'm adding green on the trees, and I'm combining a couple of colors of green here. I am going to make them look as if they have snow later on, and I'll show you how I'm going to achieve that. And finally, I'm going to use a light blue and add some shading on the snow. And of course, depending on how you are going to color it, it can be a night scene or a morning scene like mine. Now, to create the sky, I'm just going to use my Distress Oxide inks. And this is tumbled glass, I believe. I'm coming from the top towards the cabin. And of course, I'm not going to go over it. I just want to have a touch of blue at the background. Now I'm using my Wow embossing marker. This is like embossing ink, and it adds some moisture on your project. I'm adding in different areas some of that with my marker, and then I'm going to apply white embossing powder. This way the white embossing powder is going to stick where that marker was. After heat setting everything, you can see the lovely details that I got with snow on top of the branches and on the trees. And you will take a close-up look at the photo in the end of the video. So here I'm going to cut out my cardstock. This is going to be 4.25 by 5.5, and I used a satin blue cardstock by Tonic. When it comes to winter cards, I think that blues as well as silver colors match perfectly with the theme. So I used a circle die and cut out a window, and I'm not going for a shaker card here. I'm just going to stick that underneath so you can see the little scene through that window. But of course you can turn it into a shaker card as well. I'm going to use the two dies from the Hello Winter die set and cut out my word as well as the outline. For that I'm going to use the same cardstock for the word winter, and I used a white glitter cardstock for the outline. So I'm putting my word together, and I used the Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back. I place the word winter underneath my scene, and I'm going to complete the sentiment by stamping the word wishes. I stamped that with black ink on a piece of white cardstock and cut it out in a little thin strip, which I'm going to stick with glue on top of my card to complete my sentiment. And finally, instead of snow, I'm going to add some crystal gems. For that, I used my Nouveau Deluxe to add some dots of glue, and now I'm going to stick on top my snow. For my second card, I'm going to use the Precious Peony stamp set. You can see here the leaflet with a few ideas on how you can put cards together using it. I'm going to stamp one of those flower arrangements on white cardstock, and again I'm using black ink that it is alcohol marker friendly. I'm using my Misty here so that I can stamp a couple of times to get a good impression, and then I will go ahead and start coloring. For coloring, I'm using my Altenew alcohol markers, and you can see the colors that I used for the leaves and for the flowers on your screen right now. For the leaves, just because they are so small, I only used two shades of green. So at the base, I start with a darker shade and then end up with a lighter. And now for the flowers, I used 3 shades of pink, and again I'm using the same technique for from darkest to lightest, and I like to color each petal separately. It is a bit time consuming, but the results are absolutely stunning. Just like always, you will find everything I'm using for these cards linked down below in the description area. And don't forget that this is part of a blog hub, so make sure to visit my blog to find all the details on how you can enter the giveaways. So you can see here the finished result. I'm now going to use the matching die to cut it out so that I can pop it on my card. I also looked through my stash to find a cardstock that matches the colors on the flowers, and I'm adding some white splashes all over just to make the background look more interesting. By the way, this is white gesso that I have diluted with water. To add more interest on my background, I'm going to use a piece of this washi tape. This is brand new again by Altenew, and it has been released last week. I'm going to peel off the packing and stick it there. This is going to add even more interest on my background, and I have a place where I can stick on top the flower arrangement. I'm using my scissors to cut off the excess washi tape, but of course you can wrap it around at the back. Now I have some foam squares at the back of the flower arrangement. I'm going to stick it on top, and I'm going to add some sparkle on my card by adding some clear gems. So I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe to add some glue, and then I'm going to stick the gems on top. These are going to look as if they are droplets of water on my flowers. They're going to look nice and fresh. Flower cards are perfect for any occasion, so no matter what sentiment you like, you can just stamp and stick it there. I went with the one that says "So happy for you," which I have stamped with black ink on a white cardstock. I cut it out into a very thin strip, and I'm going to stick it on top of my flower arrangement to finish off my card. And I'm going to share another flower card for today. So I'm starting with a 4.25 by 5.5 white panel, which I'm going to completely cover with this new washi tape again. This is great for creating quick and simple backgrounds. The black and white stripes are really versatile, and no matter which color of flowers you choose to stick on top, it's going to help the colors pop even more. Now for this card I'm going to use one of the layering stamp sets. This is the Rosy Outlook, and you can see here the leaflet with a few ideas on how you can put your cards together. This flower has 4 layers, so I'm using a set of inks that has 4 layers as well. The set I'm using here is by Altenew, and it's called Red Sunset. And I turn my card every time so that I can stamp a second flower. Now I started with blush. I'm going to move on and stamp the second layer with rouge, the third layer with crimson, and the last layer with velvet, which is the darkest of all the inks from this set. I did use the same order of colors to stamp the smallest of the roses, and now I'm stamping the leaves. For the leaves there are 3 layers. I used greens from the Tropical Forest Altenew ink set, and I'm going with parrot. The second layer is olive, and the darkest shade is moss. So now back to my background. I have some foam squares at the back of those flowers, and I'm going to create a flower arrangement at the top of this washi tape. So for some of the elements I'm using foam tape to pop them up like the flowers, but for the stem and the leaves I'm going with glue. And again, since this is a flower card, pretty much any sentiment would go nicely with it. I just went with a simple thank you. And again I'm going to stick some gems just to make it more special and add some sparkle. Here is a close-up look on the last card for today. Don't forget to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. And also leave me a comment down below and let me know which one of those products was your favorite. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired. And I'll see you all next time.